So I've been on social media a lot this week, you know, with the whole corona issue, and I noticed that there seems to be this war being created where people of science are calling out people of religion, saying, oh, science is going to save the world, we're the ones making the cure, where are your pastors, come and pray, and all kinds of mockery and jabs are being sent the way of people of religion. And this just reminds me of during political periods where people are so busy dividing themselves against party factions and lines of PDP, APC, Democrat, Republican, forgetting that after the election is done, you will be ruled as one. They're not going to say PDP get tax cuts, APC no fuel subsidy. No, you'll be ruled as one nation and as one people. So why do we always try and divide ourselves? Why do we always try and look for what's different in us as opposed to looking for what's similar in us? Albert Einstein has a very popular quote that says, religion without science is lame, and science without religion is blind. And I think what he means by that is, okay, I'll give you an example. My cleaner told me that it was from church that she was informed about what to do for the coronavirus. So she doesn't have a smartphone, maybe she can't afford to pay for like DSTV or get information from the TV. So it was when she went to church that the pastor explained to them, you're about to wash your hands, sneeze and cough into the elbow and all those good stuff that people need to know. So even though scientists may be working hard in their labs finding the cure, churches, being that they have the community and the flock, are helping to spread the word. So you see, that's how the word moves forward, when we have an all hands on deck approach, as opposed to saying, oh, you guys do your thing, let us do our thing. Unity is what we need more than ever in these trying times, and not divisions and factions. The Pope did something really nice where I think he was trying to do the Benedictus, and he was behind this glass thing. I was, you know, blessing people, you know, trying to incorporate social distancing into the traditions of the church. So that's how we should think, you know. And the funny thing is that most of all these science people, you know, is you go to MC Square, people of math and all that, most of you forget that if you really look back to most of the founding fathers of mathematics and most of the scientists, people like Einstein, people like Newton, most of them believed in God. I think it was Isaac Newton, while he was formulating the formula for how light travels, he looked into a microscope, into a crystal, and when he saw all the light splattering in different directions, I think there's this myth where he said, tell me there is no God. You know what I mean? So I don't know why we always look for ways to divide ourselves. When a problem comes, we start looking for how to say, okay, you, us versus them. These are just the wrong mentalities to have in moving forward. Steve Jobs is very popular for saying that the intersection between science and art makes my heart sing. And that's how Steve as a person thought, Steve Jobs. He thought, okay, software, tech, design, art, put them together, boom, the iPhone, boom, millionaire. So it is even more profitable to think about things more in, okay, how is this thing and this thing similar? How can they work together? As opposed to always looking for how things are different and how they should be divided. That doesn't help you both mentally or even financially, as we can see with most of the greatest people in the world. Leonardo da Vinci, much as we know him as an artist, was one of the first people to conceptualize the airplane and draw designs for flights and even the submarine. You know, so I find that people who try to connect the dots in their head tend to be greater in life than, you know, always looking for, okay, we are science people, church people, go away, you know, and all that. Like, it's such a wrong mentality to have. Stop sending jabs at people of religion in these trying times. Religion is a very beautiful thing because it provides community, and community is something we need so much right now because of, you know, just these are trying times, and people can run mad without that support system of community. So now more than ever, I think we do need religion. And don't get me wrong, I'm not saying they're not dubious pastors and men of God out there trying to make a buck for themselves. They are, but let's not allow a few bad eggs to taint the whole, you know, the whole litter, and let's not knock an entire thing because we know one or two bad people doing it. I find that if you just remove that convert clause in religion, of go out and convert, if you just remove that clause, religion is such a beautiful thing, because if I can say I'm a Christian, you're a Muslim, you pray your way, I'll pray my way, and we'll see after prayer, there'll be no problem in the world. The problem is just always that convert, go out and convert into your own. That's where the problem always stems from. If you remove that, everything else about religions and its practices are really, really good. And don't get me wrong, I'm not preaching to you to believe in God. I'm not asking you not to be an atheist. If you want to be an atheist, be an atheist. That's your problem. Because at the end of the day, whether you're an atheist or you're a believer, either way, it is a belief. Nobody can know for sure which is real.